Maybe it's okay. Thank you very much for invitation. I'm very happy to be here. But unfortunately, I'm not familiar with bioscience or biology. Right? My field is the computer science, especially artificial intelligence and robotics. So last night, I totally changed my presentation to introduce my area and to talk about the big data and robotics. And my talk is, at the first part of my talk, I talk about what we were doing and what we are doing now. And also, and to talk about my special research subject is the machine with heart. And last, I talk about the big data and robotics. So this slide showed our long history about the robotics research for a very long time. We have been a very good team of about 10 professors are joined to this project, the robotics research in Waseda University, Tokyo. About 1970, we started a very big project about humanoid robot making. And I'll show you some example of the video of the first one. It's the left upper side. It's the world's first human-like robot. It's a very long, 2 meter tall, and about 100 kilograms. It walked by two legs, but the control system is quite primitive. So for one step, it took about 40 seconds. But the lower side of the left, you can see the more advanced biped walking robot. The robot can dance with shaking the upper body. And also, in the left upper side is another human-like robot that can understand the musical score and can play a keyboard. And the right lower side is another one. It's looking like the behavior is very human-like. Of course, this robot is not good for the industrial use, but this type of behavior is very important for the human communication. And after that, we also developed many different types of human-like robot. Now we can make a very human-like walking system, and the robot can do something like a cooking by break the eggs. And also, left lower side show another type of walking robot using a parallel link without a joint. And the left side lower is the very sophisticated robot. This is a collaboration with Toyota and the human care robot. And recently, we entered to another type of robot. The left upper side show a very small robot that can to move in the very narrow side of the vertical narrow area between the two walls that can climb up and walk around, move around. And also, the left lower side, video shows we are making a third arm for the human. Third arm means that you have two arms, but using two arms, you can do another thing using the third arm. I show this is very primitive type, and we are now developing a new one. And using this type of robot, you can do many things. Hold the human with two arms and hit the bicep, something like that. And also, we are making many different type of human machine interface, and that can use a robot machine with two free hands and using the right lower is you can see the already see the moving the wheelchair with mouse interface. You can control the wheelchair with a mouse, the tongue motion. And these days, we are entering human care robot. The upper side video shows the walk assistant machine. And also, recently, we established a new company to make a restoration robot for Fukushima Daiichi, again, power plant. This is a very big robot to construction. And the right side is a very funny the animation robot, Gundam, is very famous in the world. This is size is 18 meters in total. Now we are doing a new project, 5-year project, to make this real size robot move in the public. So last year we called a new idea how we can move such a big robot to the world. And just 3 months ago, we selected some ideas. And next year, we'll do an open discussion about how to design such a robot. And the 2 years later, we'd do a very precise design with a robot. And the company, the corporate company, will build such a robot. And maybe we are selecting the place of this robot. The show near the Haneda International Airport. So you can see the robot when you come to the Tokyo Olympics. And so in these histories, we are considering about what is most important for robot and human interconnections or interactions. In the historical view, the first command or way of interaction to machine is something like the switch. So that means the physical instruction to the machines. We call it the body or physics. And the next one, we use a command, which we call the logic. Something like a word, command word, walk or stop, something like that. And nowadays, in the industrial area, we can use another type of command that we call it a numeric. Advance by 1 meter or the rotate 45 degrees, something like that. You can give a command with numeric the values. And also, recently, we are entering a new area of such a human-machine interaction. In this system, in the new system, we can use something the fuzzy command. For instance, walk a little bit faster or something. So speak more loudly or something. This is to show the degree, not numeric. And also, the most advanced researchers are entering the new field of such a human-machine interaction. That means you can use the quality, the instruction, the dance elegantly or something, or draw beautifully. In such a command should be used in the future to make the machine more human-like. No. Yeah, but anyway. And so in this history, something like the objective command system is already prepared. But now we are entering to another system. We call it the subjective command system. We use a symbol information in this system. So in Japan, about 20 years ago, we have a community to talk about or research about the kansei issue. Kansei means a Japanese word, meaning is something like sensitivity or the emotion. So this is schematic diagram of the human-like robot to make a true human-like robot. Human-like is very meaning, but in this scheme, I want to say that robot must have, of course, body. And this means that robot is a physical existence in the world. And robot can feel the force or touch with the body surface. And also, the recent intelligent robot has a brain. Brain means, in this case, usually logical thinking way robot can do. And also, reasoning is very important issue for the robot making. So body and brain, we call it intelligent machine. But for the true intelligence, we need another functionality of the brain. We call it kansei. Kansei means something like intuitiveness or sense of feeling or tacit information. So what I call the kansei is, of course, the Japanese word. About 20 years ago, many researchers in Japan joined from the robotics, information science, and psychology, and physiology joined there, and we talked how to express such a functionality in English paper. But we could not find the good word, so we used the kansei itself, even in English paper. So the recently, the similar word is used in the United States and Europe, that is affective computing or something. So anyway, with kansei, we call it another human ability of understanding. And also in Japan, the kansei is governed by kokoro. Kokoro is heart. The maybe the similar feeling in English have this heartwarming movie or something. So we call it the kokoro is a virtual organ governing kansei functionality of human. The kansei exists in our chest, not in head. This is very similar in the Europe and other countries. And also, kansei functionality cannot be described with a compact rule set. So I'll say it is essentially related to big data issue. And this is a very the simple slide that to show the approaches to realize a machine with a heart. The one way is top-down approach. They imitate human or creature behavior that looks like to have kokoro or heart. The design based on knowledge. So in this case, you can use many different big data about the human behavior related to the emotional the function of behaviors. So, but this is something like a slave machine. I want to talk about another way is a bottom up. This is a design based on experience. Make seed and design the environment to feed the machine. This is an imitation of something like a biology or the biological system and accept their growth. So in this area, we need something like meta-algorithm, something like a machine learning or self-organization. And we can have an ego organism or ego machine. So the grow rather than make. This is true in my feeling that because in the field of engineering, not only engineering, but also science and the social science, the increasing complexity is very large. So the design is possible, but inspection is impossible. This is very commonly taught in the design of the software. And the completeness is the rather now that we cannot expect the completeness of the system, just we can expect the feasibility of the system. So the, about the autonomous generation, that means the birth of the machine. The, we do not do the detailed design, but we can design the environment, that in this environment that the machine will grow up. So that we can cultivate a machine. And software to use harvest is more important than the software to the program the machine behavior. We call it that this is an ecological design. The similar the behavior is done in agriculture. The farmers don't know the biology, that they have a very experience. But they can do, the, they can make the vegetables and the weeds. And also pottery is the same. The designers or artists don't know about the heat interaction to the soil, but they have many experience and they can make a very good design, the pottery. So in this line, the, I'm making, I'm doing a very recent research is, the one is the, for the future direction, I want to be on program the, in the software. That is learning, for the machine learning, and also knowledge acquisition through the real world, moving machines. And another one is hardware, the beyond metal and silicon. As long as we use a metal and silicon for robot, we can not go further. So this trial, we are making chemical robotics using a gel body, and chemical reaction is going on in the gel. And we can make a worm-like robot. We need no wiring, no assembling in this system. And the lower part of the slide shows a very primitive trial to make a crystal. The, at here, the, you can see in the left-hand side, the plastic cube, that is the parts. And we modify the surface of the parts, the cube, and put it in the weak acid liquid and squeeze it and control the temperature. On the surface of the cube, you can find the solder and you can have something like crystal. And also left-hand side is a gene-like the self-reproduction. So you can, in the lower side, its upper side is the seed gene, and the lower side, lower is the producted, produced the copy of the body. And much more, the difficult thing is the philosophy to make something like a creature. We have to beyond the Asimov. The three laws of Asimov is very the famous, and he said the three laws of robot making. But in my feeling, this is too much human-centric ideas. So if we want to make a real human-like or human-friendly or a robot, then we have to overcome the, such a Asimov's law. This is my consideration. The time is limited, so I want to say about the scientific approach and engineering approach. I want to stress that engineering approach is different from science. That it may not be possible to understand Kokoro completely by science, but it is, however, possible to create Kokoro by engineering. This is my consideration. And about the data, big data and robot. The robot is computer plus body. That means AI with mobility. And the robot is mobile sensor. And the robot is actuator sensor complex. So that means the robot makes Internet of Things more flexible and richer. And distributed sensors is nowadays big data problem is upward stream. Many distributed sensors give the data to the center. But using robot is a sort of the distributed actuator. So you can use such a network to distribute the downstream of the information. But this type of research is not done yet. And also about the big data for robotics, that we are considering to use a big data scheme for robot AI, that is view-based positioning. That means we do not calculate the positioning from the view. But in this system, we have many enormous big data of the view. For instance, 10 meter cube area, if we want to positioning with the accurate of 1 centimeter, then we have to have a big database of the image of the 1,000 times 1,000 times 1,000 and 360 the accurate 1 degree of 1 degree for the direction. Then it becomes about 10 million. So if we can have and treat the 10 million images, then we only have a new system for the positioning from the database. In the same way, sensing data based on environmental understanding is also possible. And also the synthesis by synthesis and the synthesis by synthesis, synthesis by analysis is become possible for robotics. This is quite different from the science, the methodology. And also, we can use a big data system for the database control. Many years we have a new technique for the computer science, the software that we call the table lookup system. Instead of calculation, we prepare the table of the calculation result. Then we can pull out the result very rapidly without calculation. So we can use this system with for the pre-calculated complex control for the robot. So in such a way, the big data, the algorithm can be used for robot control. So the big data lookup, we call it. And calculation become a data retriever, quite different from the different traditional way. And so the experience exchange among robots distributed over the world is quite new ideas for the robot behavior control. And what happened once will happen again. So we can expect from the big data that comes out very useful the information. So the strategy will change from task specific to environment specific. So, and also this is the last topic I want to say is big data in systems. When I was young, I read a paper of John von Neumann. He's very famous in the computer science and also physics. And this is the paper. The title is Probabilistic Logic and the Synthesis of Reliable Organism from Unreliable Component. So this lecture was made more than 50 years ago in the California Caltech. So this means the complete system consists of incomplete parts. That means we can make a complete system with incomplete parts. This is very important. In my feeling, I think that this is might be the principle of democracy. And his idea is the most key point is parts must be independent. And there should be many differences and diversity among the parts. And also free interaction is very important. to make the system more reliable than each part. So this can be said something like open data policy. So that's all I want to say. And we need a new paradigm or a new philosophy to accept everything. So the future is not allowed to see, but the open for creation. And this is the last slide. Thank you very much for your kind attention. The day before yesterday, I came here. I found the Vatican big data. Thank you very much.